In this video, we're going to show you how the Fluke 729 connects to a HART transmitter. First thing you do is, of course, connect up your milliamp jacks to the transmitter, to your plus and minus. Connect up your pressure line from the Fluke 729 to the transmitter as well. And then press the HART button. You're now on the HART pulling screen. It's trying to find the device. Two things you need to do. One, you need to enable that 250 ohm internal HART resistor. And two, press F2 to turn on loop power. Once the Fluke 729 sees the transmitter, it will display it up on the screen. And at this point, you can just press F4 to continue to select that device. Here it's reading the information on the transmitter. And then the screen you'll see next are the selections for looking at HART data, service, and calibration. Let's take a look at the first one, HART data. Now, there's a couple ways you can select any of the choices on the screen. One is just by pressing the down arrow keys and hitting continue, or you can just select the number of the setting. For example, press 1, takes you right into it. On this screen, this is the HART data. These are all the calibration-specific commands that HART is able to see here. So if you notice at the very top, you got the tag ID. Here you can actually change the tag ID name. Then you can also come down, select unit type, and also go down and check your upper and lower range. At this point, you can also go in and modify that value. It could change the upper range to something different by pressing enter, and then go ahead and make your change. Notice down below, it is showing you what the default values range are for that particular transmitter. So I could go anywhere from minus to up to 300 PSI. When you enter your new selection, just press send or press cancel to go back. Speaking of back, the back button's really nice on this product. If I press back, watch, it just takes me right back to the menu. So you can pretty much go anywhere on your screens using your back button. You get all the way back to the very beginning if you want. Let's look at HART service. So I'm just gonna go down arrow, hit continue, takes me into service. From here, I can set my PV0 trim. I can go down to trim my 4 to 20 milliamp output, or I can also trim to applied values on the sensor, as well as the other features like rearranging the transmitter and other features. Again, back button takes you right back to the start. Choice number 3 goes into doing an ad hoc calibration. Number 4 allows you to do a calibration from a task which you've downloaded from DPC Track 2, ProCal V5, or another supported software. And then the last choice, 5, allows the 729 to go out and pull the bus again.